prayer service. I'm very glad all of you are here and taking your lunch time to be here. I appreciate that very much. We have a guest in your bulletin who will be giving some context and history for the National Day of Prayer. But before I bring him up, I'd like to take a moment of privilege to say just a couple of things. I was talking about this before we got started, and if you're like me, then times around now can feel awfully divided. And even today, there are different groups meeting in different places to offer their prayer, even as we think of the National Day of Prayer as a day for unity. So, on a day when all people of goodwill are called to come together, it's perhaps disheartening to see that even in Abilene, it is difficult to bring different people or different groups together. But fortunately, unity is not dependent on uniformity. We do not need to have one prayer service. And I find hope in the fact that this day, not just here, but around Abilene and around the country, there is a panoply of people, groups, faiths, all voicing their thanks and concerns for the nation. No matter with whom we pray, or where we pray, or when we pray, today is a day of unity because we're joined with a common cause, and that's what unites us. And as for the Abilene Interfaith Council's service here at the Center for Contemporary Arts, we seek to represent diverse religious voices of the big country as they pray for the big country, the nation, and the world. As I've found the prayers and the diversity represented in previous years to be beautiful, I can't think of a better place for our prayer service than here at the Center for Contemporary Arts. And as a Presbyterian, I trust that God hears all of these prayers, no matter where they are, where they're offered, and I can't think of a better place to connect with the divine and with others than in a place that's as beautiful as this one. So allow me to express thanks to the Center for Contemporary Arts for hosting us. They're gracious every year to do so. And if you're curious about how to support the Center for Contemporary Arts or for how to become more involved in the Abilene Interfaith Council's activities, I encourage you to find me or a Center for Contemporary Art representative who may be floating around somewhere. I noticed a donation box. They probably won't even notice that. You can find that. That would be wonderful. Thank you again for coming. Welcome. And without further ado, please join me in welcoming Dr. Moore.
Jason, he says I'm supposed to hold this, so I guess it's kind of like a statue. But we are grateful to be here and to have this on a continuing basis. We've done this for several years now. And what I would like to offer are some thoughts about the reason that we have a National Day of Prayer. One thought comes to my mind before I really get into my prepared remarks is that I wonder how many places in the world there could really be an open, free event like this. And for that, we can be grateful that we can do that here in this country and in this community. Throughout history, people have demonstrated a desire to find meaning in life. They have sensed the need to reach beyond themselves for life's purpose and value. We all set forth on our journey in various paths of faith. Faith is a path. Faith describes a person's intellectual or mental beliefs as well as a conduct of life. Faith for many people involves what we call the practice of prayer. Prayer provides an individual as well as a group the opportunity to communicate with the ultimate source of their faith. Prayer involves praise to God, the Creator, thanksgiving for the blessings of life, petition for the needs of others and ourselves, and the resolve to be a responsible world citizen. Today is designated as National Day of Prayer. In 1775, the year prior to the Declaration of Independence in this country, the Continental Congress made a request that the people of the colonies pray for wisdom in forming a nation. The nation became the United States of America. In the midst of crises, wars, numerous challenges, the practice of prayer has been a significant thread that's been woven into the tapestry of this country and its citizens. The year 1791 marks the approval of the first 10 amendments to the U.S. Constitution, a mere 2 years after the ratification of the U.S. Constitution, which was in 1789. These 10 amendments we know as the Bill of Rights. These documents set forth a new model in the history of civilization. A diverse citizenry of languages, cultures, and religious faiths have the privilege to live together with respect and trust and friendship. The very first amendments present 5 freedoms in the following order. Freedom of religion, which is interesting that that comes first in the first amendments. Freedom of religion, then freedom of speech, freedom of press, freedom of people peaceably to assemble, and freedom to petition the government for a redress of grievance. And on this National Day of Prayer, in this very room, we exercise 3 of these 5 freedoms. The freedom of religion, the freedom of speech, and the freedom of people peaceably to assemble. We do well in this hour not to rush through these moments or take this occasion for granted. May each of us allow the opportunity to deepen our own faith while respecting the freedom of others to express and experience their personal faith. Reflect on the heritage of your faith. Learn from the voices of others, both in prayer and conversation. Experience a fresh commitment to the value of prayer in our personal lives, in our community, and in the world at large. The Abilene Interfaith Council desires to have occasions like this to promote communication, understanding, and peace, and goodwill among individuals of different religious faiths. You may use the printed program for the list of those who will now be offering prayers of their faith. You will notice the religious tradition as each individual prays, as listed in the program. We express our gratitude for each person who expresses their faith through prayer to be here. They will now come in the order shown in the program, one after the other. So if you'll follow the program, we'll continue. Thank you.
Take away the arrogance and hatred which infest our hearts. Break down the walls that separate us. Unite us in bonds of love. And work through our struggle and confusion to accomplish your purpose on earth, that in your good time, all nations and races may serve you in harmony around your heavenly throne. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Hello, everyone. The central theme of the Baha'i Faith is unity of mankind and universal peace. In the early 1900s, Abdu'l-Bahá, who is one of the central figures of the Baha'i Faith, came to the United States to promulgate this message. And he revealed a prayer for the America, and I would like to share that prayer with you today. O thou kind Lord, this gathering is turning to thee. These hearts are radiant with thy love. These minds and spirits are exhilarated by the message of thy glad tidings. O God, let this American democracy become glorious in spiritual degrees, even as it has aspired to material degrees, and render this just government victorious. Confirm this revered nation to upraise the standard of the oneness of humanity, to promulgate the most great peace, to become thereby most glorious and praiseworthy among all the nations of the world. O God, this American nation is worthy of thy favors and deserving of thy mercy. Make it precious and near to thee through thy bounty and bestowal. Abdu'l-Baha.
Regrettably, Noel Singleton can't be with us today, so I'd like to invite Jason to offer.
Hi, I'm Jason Williams, representing Roman Catholic Church. I wanted to echo what Jacob said to kick off the meeting, was that this nation needs healing in multiple ways, and this nation has a lot of anxiety. Before I get too political, let me just jump into Philippians 4 that talks a little about that. Have no anxiety at all, but in everything, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, make your requests known to God. Then the peace of God that surpasses all understanding will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, brothers, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is gracious, if there is any excellence, if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. Keep on doing what you have learned, received, and heard, and seen in me. And I always like to bring up our current Pope, Pope Francis. He's very popular in our church. He's actually very popular throughout the world, even in the secular world. It seems more and more he believes in a big tent policy, meaning we want more and more different types of people and not just one, not closing the church doors. So that's something that I love about Pope Francis, and a lot of the world does. Real quick, I'll do a Hail Mary for you guys. You might have heard it before. It's Hail Mary, full of grace, our Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Seen Abdullah, so I'm not sure. Okay, Abdullah's not here. Sorry about that. Is April here? Yes.
My name is April Powers, and I'm giving you our prayer for peace from the Jewish religion. May we see the day when war and bloodshed cease, when a great peace will embrace the whole world. Then nation will not threaten nations, and mankind will not again know war. For all who live on earth shall realize we have not come into being to hate or to destroy. We have come into being to praise, to labor, and to love. Compassionate God, bless the leaders of all the nations with the power of compassion. Fulfill the promise conveyed in Scripture. I will bring peace to the land, and you shall lie down, and no one shall terrify you. I will rid the land of vicious beasts, and it shall not be revenged by war again. Let love and justice flow like a mighty stream. Let peace fill the earth as the waters fill the sea. And let us say, Amen.
I contemplated the theme.
fly under the unity banner, I thought, what would really represent that, that unity of all of us? And I thought, what came to me was time and space. So I brought two prayers. One was written in 1898, so that's the timepiece. And I also brought the prayer from our poet laureate, James Dillard Freeman, that is now present on the moon, and so that's the space part. So the first prayer, I'll just talk about them just a bit more, and then I'll just go into the prayer, so there's just an unbroken chain of prayer. The first prayer was continues to be a favorite of ours. And it was a favorite of Myrtle Fillmore, who was one of the co-founders of the Unity Movement. And she has a remarkable healing story, so I really resonate with what's been said already about healing this being that time. And then the second, obviously, is the prayer from our area. So I'll begin. The prayer of faith. God is my help in every need. God does my every hunger feed. God walks beside me, guides my way through this every moment of this day. I now am wise, I now am true, patient and kind and loving too. All things I am, can do, and be, through Christ the truth that is in me. God is my health, I can't be sick. God is my strength, unfailing, quick. God is my all, I know no fear, since God and love and truth are here. I Am There by James Dillard Freeman. Do you need me? I am there. You cannot see me, yet I am the light you see by. You cannot hear me, yet I speak through your voice. You cannot feel me, yet I am the power at work in your hands. I am at work, but you do not understand my ways. I am at work, but you do not recognize my works. I am not strange visions or mysteries. Only in absolute stillness beyond self can you know me as I am. And then, but as a feeling and a faith. Yet I am there, yet I hear, yet I answer. When you need me, I am there. Even if you deny me, I am there. Even when you feel most alone, I am there. Even in your fears, I am there. Even in your pain, I am there. I am there when you pray and when you do not pray. I am in you and you are in me. Only in your mind can you feel separate. For me, only in your mind are the mists of yours and mine. Yet only with your mind can you know me and experience me. Empty your heart of empty fears. When you get yourself out of the way, I am there. You can of yourself do nothing, but I can do all, and I am in all. But you may not see the good. Good is there, for I am there. I am there because I have to be, because I am. Only in me does the world have meaning. Only out of me does the world take form. Only because of me does the world go forward. I am the law on which the movement of the stars and the growth of living cells are founded. I am the love that is laws fulfilling. I am assurance. I am peace. I am oneness. I am the law you can live by. I am the love you can cling to. I am your assurance. I am your peace. I am one with you. I am. Though you fail to find me, I do not fail you. Through your faith in me is unsure. My faith in you never wavers, because I know you, because I love you. Beloved, I am there. Amen.
One to the matron of our pantheon, which is Frigg, the wife of the chief god Odin, who is the holder of harmony within the family and the tribe, and also to the female relatives of all of us, our great female ancestors. Hail, great Frigg, wise and knowing mother, queen of Asgard, mistress in your own right of your home. Your guiding hands pull order from chaos in the universe. Your keen eyes see the secret patterns of our existences. Your presence makes the shifting soils beneath our feet solid. Beloved goddess, both fair and firm, wary and watchful but ever hopeful, perceptive and aware but perpetually amused, guardian of children, defender of family, holder of harmony of blood and tribe, heart of the home, home of our hearts. We thank you for your blessings. We ask for your guidance and patience as we work together in all nine worlds. Show us the strength of being a soft warrior. Hail, great mother Frigg. Hail to Seer, wise grandmothers, steadfast mothers, strong aunts, brave sisters, female ancestors of us all. Those who made and gave and supported life and scratched forth our lives from nothing. We ask you for your guidance and patience and wisdom in helping us work together as you work together for us to be here today. We are but foolish babes at your plentiful breasts. Please help us grow and walk upon our own two unstable feet, hand in hand, ignoring our differences, embracing our shared experiences, and remembering what is most important in this life. Our people are our wealth. We are only poor when we have no people or no tribe. We will not squander the sacrifices you have made for us to be here. We know the ways of war. Please help us learn the ways of peace. Thank you for your love and guidance, female ancestors.
For then we can share that which we have with those who have less. Thank you for your presence during the holy days. For then we are able to celebrate you and our families and our friends. For those who have no voice, we ask you to speak. For those who feel unworthy, we ask you to pour your love out in waterfalls of tenderness. For those who live in pain, we ask you to bathe them in the river of your healing. For those who are lonely, we ask you to keep them company. For those who are depressed, we ask you to shower upon them the light of hope. Dear Creator, we ask you to give to all the world that which we need most, peace. In Christ, amen.
Thank you.
Thank you.